Heyo. Can you hear the music? Is it louder than me, or can you hear me just fine? Noise. Oh, Joan. I think I accidentally drew Ana de Armas. Oh, I did. So far, so good. Yeah, I grew up with it. My brother snuck me into the theater for the movie when I was 11. The animator, freelance animator, known as Tristan Zammit, put out a call that he was putting together, working on a project, he needed animators. I threw my hat in the pile, and I was lucky enough to land it and got to do a few shots. I really did very little, like so many other people kicked ass on that video. Like, just our 3D guys, our compositors made that all sing. So, yeah, I had a hand in it, and I'm super grateful, but yeah, I just don't want to, I want to set the record straight. I didn't do, like, most of it. Most of it was, like, Tristan and the rest of the team. But yeah, I do not personally know any of them. I think I preferred Metallica just because I'm more familiar with them. And it was more fun, the kind of stuff I got to draw, I think. Oh, yeah, no, I'm insanely grateful. Yeah. Are you that was pretty cool. That was the most amount of like actual animating I did. Tristan was really cool letting me utilize my strengths as an illustrator first. But I am pretty proud of that moment where James just goes, "You are your matzi at me." It's pretty fun. Favorite horror movie? I definitely love The Evil Dead. The Evil Dead 2, to be specific. But then there's like horror of like what I actually like. Like, entertainment versus horror, like what I actually find horrifying. Like what is actually scary to me. I haven't seen it in forever. I've probably blocked most of it out, but aliens can get to me, like the fourth kind and stuff. Hiya, Labby. Yeah, more entertainment. I liked Malignant. Yeah, Evil Dead 2. I mean, you know, Alien, classic. I want to like Event Horizon more, but I just think Dead Space did it better. Got me into drawing. Just wanted to create worlds, characters, and it was my escape, and there was nothing much to do where I grew up. Just, you know, entertain yourself for hours, and I couldn't really do much else. So I completely specced into it. Oh, no, this. Give me one sec. The software is cool, but it also fucking sucks sometimes. Because I'm streaming through my PC. Yeah, Suspiria is pretty sweet. I love. That's an interesting movie where, like, the original soundtrack and Tom York's soundtrack for the reboot. Both fucking rock in different ways. I think I can do a passable Peter Griffin impression. Ah. Well, I'm already from Rhode Island, so it wouldn't be that much of a stretch. And now, utter darkness. Could it be? Are we back? Hello, X underscore X. Holy crap, Lois. Ah, this is freaking sweet. Hey, Lois. Diarrhea. That's all you get. I could do a much better Stewie.
Brian, the fat man, is here.
Oh, yes, yes. Soon the world will be mine.
Giggity, giggity. All right.
Hey, Peter.
Peter, I'm gonna let you answer that question.
Samurai fool.
Yeah.
I have not. Yeah, I think that's sick that they keep showing Gendy's shit. Oh no, we have a leak.
Thank you.
Oh, fuck. I did this in a stupid way. It's okay. Everything's going to be alright. Genndy Tartakovsky is a prolific animator, definitely an inspiration on me. Look at that. I got a color in her lips. watch the new Clone High. I was filled with all that good, good angst of a show I love. So I needed to draw sad art. I love Pyro. Yeah. Sniper has always been my main favorite class. And people who are annoyed with him, there are definitely some tweaks I'm open to, but he's like so useless if you just gang up on it. Like he's, you can't do shit. Jimmy Neutron. I'm just catching up. You're probably wondering what I'm doing with this can of gasoline. How do layers work? I am in Procreate, so if you're talking about Photoshop, it's a kind of a different system, but yeah. I don't know if I can give an easy answer to that. Well, what do you want to know about layers specifically? Yeah, animating on paper. Did that in school. Glad I don't have to do it again.
Gotcha.
I like the new designs. I don't have any issue with it. I'm a little confused as to why people are up about it. Mainly it comes down to the characters from the original cast are a lot simpler because that is how, like, it was hand-drawn, like, so they had to be simple in order to work. Now, because things are done digitally puppeted with tweening, you can have a lot more detail. And yeah, I think, like, Confucius as, like, an influencer, yeah, it's funny, makes sense. Frida Kahlo with, like, an overly kind of busy design, as she was a very troubled artist in real life, makes sense. Harriet Tubman is probably the only character that probably needs a little bit more personality to her, which I'm sure they'll flesh out. That's kind of the genius thing about Clone High, is that it's like how these clones choose to interpret and either mimic or do have to walk a completely different path. And it seems like, yeah, there's still room for Harriet's character to change. You know, dyeing her hair, being, you know, she's not really trying to emulate the original, but, you know, I have no issue. The only thing that stuck out to me, which was a kind of two-parter, is that, like, I mean, Cleo's voice is different, which is really weird because everyone else's is, like, spot on. And the other thing is, they haven't used Cleo at all. So I hope she becomes more regularly intertwined, because I hope it's not like some weird thing where it's like, I don't know if the original actress like died or just wasn't available or something, but I just hope it's not something where it's like they put her in the background more because they don't have the same voice actor. But yeah. Oh yeah. I mean, Genghis Khan was there in the original. A lot of them are still there in the original. I definitely miss Toots. Anime Joan. Yeah, bulky characters are fun. Look at this Evangelion ass frame. digitally. You can get... I have a screen protector that makes it feel more like paper. Yeah. Pasta, where the hell have you been? Yeah, Pasta was there. He's responsible for the inception of Shoot the Moon. I've got a lot of memories of Shoot the Moon. I got my first white hairs because of trying to finish that fucking thing during the height of senior year. The best memory was... Yeah. Pasto, it all started because Pasto came up with the ending. And we were just cackling at the idea of the image of, yeah, like instead of shoot for the moon, just like some guy trying to shoot the actual moon. Yeah. There you go.
No need for caps lock, buddy. But anyway.
Yeah, the best memory was when we had a screening at the end of the year. That's right, yeah, if a gun would work in space. And anyway, the best memory I have is, like, showing it. Oh, that's really kind of you. Like, it... Having it be a project that a lot of people... A lot of people ended up finding funny because, you know, you spend so long on something. Like, I spent a year on it, and it's just like you're like all the jokes, like, you're not sure if they're funny anymore, and you're second guessing everything, and you're like, oh my god, this is gonna feel like an eternity because it was so long. And if it's not funny, it's gonna feel like it's like an hour long. And luckily, it landed, and a lot of people resonated with it, and to me the biggest piece of pride and joy I got was my friends who helped me write it. Seeing them, like, react to it and love it, and that's what made it all worth it. Thank you. The mixed media was born out of the necessity to finish and cutting corners and having no budget. Professional voice acting. It's very kind of you. A lot of the voices in a lot of my stuff is... Sometimes it's me. It's mostly Pasto, who is Chewbacca Pasto in the chat. And my other buddy, Ethan. I can do some voices, for sure. It would be fun. I would like to do it. But, yeah, I don't know. I spec more into drawing, but if I could do both, I'd gladly do it. So, thank you. I mean, yeah, favorite character in Clone High. I mean, the show gets to have his cake and eat it too, of being this, like, Degrassi, like, high school angst kind of thing. I definitely like, I mean, I just love the conception of the main cast, and I don't know, like, I love them all. It's hard to, like, pick one. But it's probably Joan. Joan is probably my favorite. Yeah. Yeah, my way into the industry is YouTube. It's social media. I'm eternally grateful for you guys sticking with me. Because yeah, I could try to climb up the ranks, you know, the traditional way, in hopes that, like, oh, you know, I put in my years, I put in my dues, someday I'll be rewarded. They'll give me a show, they'll give me this. It's weirdly more viable now. I was just talking about this earlier with a friend of mine, how it's kind of backwards, where that is what you did in the past. It's like you were a no one and you worked your way up, whereas now you're possibly in a stronger position where it's like sometimes you get hired and people already know you because they're like, oh my god, I saw that thing, that short you did, I saw Don't Thug Me, like, that was sick. And it's just surreal because it's like, you know, I think of like my dad's generation, where it's like you had to, like, come to work as a goddamn professional, work your way up to build that kind of credit from nothing, working at a studio. But now you could be from anywhere doing anything and just kind of make yourself, make your own portfolio, don't ask for permission, get to a position where, like, so many animators greenlight and do their own pilots on YouTube. Or kickstart stuff. So yeah, and that's the other thing. Yeah, like, because companies still don't put enough faith in animated media being able to sell on its own, they get celebrity voice actors to do things, and it can be real hit and miss. Because voice acting takes a very specific kind of acting. You just do it. Acting with your voice is so easy. The cast of Cowboy Bebop could have been someone off the street. Yeah, you could get... Yeah, by that logic, yeah. It's like, man, I could work for free on, like, 10 million things, but I gotta, like, pay bills. I gotta pay bills. Voice crack. I got to pay bills. Isn't that right, Abe? I gotta pay bills. Whoa. Maybe I should do, like, an animation like this, where it's just, like, crappy screen recordings. It's like, oh. Whoa.
Gotta pay bills.
No more hands.
Oh yeah, doesn't he have sideburns? Pasto, if you're still here, this Abe is starting to look like just a wiry version of you. I forget where his mole is. It's like either on that side or the other side. This is anime.
I gotta look this up. Does he have? I can't remember.
That's what's throwing me off. Okay, yeah. They do go past his ears. Yeah, that's closer to Abe. His hair goes down, not out. I was like, I don't remember Abe looking cool. Mole wrong too. Oh my god, I'm a failure.
Oh, Jables.
Thank you. Thank you, Joe.
Pencil neck pasto. Whoa. Always fill your lines, kids. This is how we color the shadows. Wow, not what I wanted. Yeah, I've seen Meat Canyon stuff. It's fucking awesome. Jealous of the fucking bastard. could see what it looks like. Nah, that doesn't. Yeah, the designs on clonehigh are genius. To boil down Kennedy, to just these kind of like just the downward angled eyes.
My dinner or your dinner?
Well, I had a burrito for lunch. Might get some kimchi fried rice. That could hit the spot. El Jefe's, I very much enjoy. Their steak burrito kicks ass. The Amelia's in Alston burned down, which fucking sucked. Danke. Danke. Yeah, what am I looking at? That big collar. Crap, I totally forgot what I was looking at. Oh, yeah. Unforgivable.
The roommate tier list. The fabled roommate tier list.
Low power mode.
I don't know if I know Solid JJ. Let me do a quick lookup. Oh, well, these aren't animations, right? These are just, like, he's just dubbing stuff. which is funny. I think I've definitely seen some of this guy's stuff, yeah, for sure. But yeah. Yep, don't know. Well, anyway, I'm gonna sign off for now. It's been awesome. Thanks so much for hanging out, everyone. Catch you guys later.